Right, got myself a drink. I'm all ready to go. Go and see if we can finish this today then, shall we? Trying to remember what I had left to do. I know I've got the rest of the knights to find. Which bonfire was I at though? I have a habit of going back to Majula and then forgetting where I'm supposed to be. Have a look. So I need to top on life gems first. So grab some more of these. Got plenty of them. You're fully upgraded. I could probably do with putting the repair powders on my bar. Maybe getting a few more. Head to the castle and grab a few more because the bone fist breaks quickly. So we'll grab some more repair powders for the next bit. And then we'll go back and find some more knights. Oh, someone's signs. Beam goddess and archangelus, they'll be for down there. Where we're going later. Go up here. I do love the stun on the bone fist. It stuns things so well. And then there's that knockdown. Right. We'll see the dude up here and get a few extra repair powders.
Welcome, our guests. Tell me.
Yada yada yada. Right. Fill an infinite amount. We'll have 5.
Gone so soon. Be safe on.
Have any souls on me? No. Use the feather because I'm lazy. Seeing as it's an infinite homeward bone, we may as well. So now we're going back to good old Aleum Lois, and we were at the second bonfire. I can't quite remember now. Go have a look. This is the one? Yeah, this is the one through the floor. This is the right area. Punch souls. Love to see that stagger. We've got plenty of assassins up there. That one up there then. Get this, see, she's already coming. There. Here comes the second one. Dropped us her robe as well. Third one is just still sat there. Fourth. Oh, you're supposed to stay staggered. There. We have this assassin. now to show you all the dumbest moves. Oh, it doesn't actually do that much damage. Must be more of a stagger thing to that one. You taken out. Got another assassin there. This dude up the steps. So, here we use, shall we? Oh, it's two of them here. Right. Yeah, you dealt with radiant life gem, nice. This body up here has an item on it. How do you get to it? I can't see any obvious way to get up there unless it's on the other side. Yeah, unless I'm supposed to come over from that side or something. Bring it in short, hurrah for detour. Yeah, this is the one we saw before. Oh! Go around here. What do you got? Dark dance. You're a spell. Sounds like a hex, actually. Yeah, it is. Hex converts souls into a large, massive dark, momentous, massive dark dance. Signal of joy at its own release. That's merely to taunt frozen spheres towards them. Yes, that's like the homing spell. So, back round this way. Up into the tower kind of area. Batty. Right, up we go. It's dead end. Oh yeah, this is the big building, isn't it? Right. Does not open this. Whoa! I forgot that they could throw lances. Oh well, if you're gonna heal, then I'm gonna heal. And you can get backstabbed again. Ignore those, they lead to the challenge area. Got this dude in here. With these chests that are now available. And this one. Oi! This one on the far right was the mimic, wasn't it? Let's see. Yeah, it was. Got ya. Katarina armor. It's the onion armor. Another Titanite slab. Seven old radiant life gems. Cool. Bonfire ascetics, 3 of them. And 2 bright bugs. Got another lancer. Ow. There we go. Got him with a backstab that time. And then... oh! There we go. So, forgive me a second, my game capture that I can see just crashed. I can't see anything. Just fixed it, there we go. Yeah, I've got the game shows on OBS. The actual game capture program is what I use to view it on my PC. And that crashed for a second. Well, that's all unlocked now. We've got this bit to the left as well. The invisible dude's still here. Or are they visible now? Take this dude out first. Stayed away and healed. Right then. At least I know exactly where I'm going now, and I could skip most of these. Like, if I just leg it through all this. I wonder how many of them will follow me through. Ignore this lancer. Ignore that door because I've got everything in there. If I head over this way. Got this lancer and maybe the assassin if it pulls me out here. There. How did he still get to heal? That's not fair. So well staggered him then. Deep bugger in on. Tell you what. Ah no, he's left. Right, so we've got this way. And we've got... I kinda wanna see what's down there. Do I have... I do have a Pharaoh's Lockstone. No more invisible dudes, are they dead? Yeah, it looks like they're all dead, because if I still had the... because I've got the thingy on now that lets me see invisible dudes. Let's see what this does. I'm just curious. But here have Durgo's hat. What do you look like? This hat. Even comes with a cool monocle. Boost range of bows. Monocle hat. Favor by blue eyed Durgo extends arrow range. Oh well. We're going to see what's down this way, and then we've got to the left as well through that tower. So. Oi, who's shooting at me? Oh, Lancer Man is back. Don't like fighting on this little ledge. Come on. There. We've got this area. Need more staggers. Have a quick nosy then. What's up through the tower up here? That's what we've got. Hey, there was a frozen chest. Elizabeth mushrooms, also a really good healing item. Right, let's see what's over here. Apart from this assassin. You, Niki. Yeah, so that's where they come up. There's another Lancer here. Rampart Golem armor. Got that bit that leads down, and this bit that goes up. So that's where the hidden ladder was. This is the bit with the dogs. Yeah, it is. Lovely. Another dog. Get rid of that one. Maybe a bit of a run around. Oh well, practice kiting. Out. Thank you. That was lucky. And he got me. Fuck off. I had come out of power stance and didn't realise. Right. Right, back into power stance. There. What we want. So we can just leg it through. But after that bit with the Lancer, where the Pharaoh's Lockstone was, I think I'm going to go down those steps. So ignore this Lancer. I can always backtrack if I need to. Ignore you. Come out over this way. I wonder. Oh no, he backs off. Got him. And there we go. Down these steps. Oh, we're gonna get you out. Oop. Guys with spears. I might need to do this, like the trip combo with them. So. Make sure we're in power stance. Here we are. Pop one of these. Past all these buggers. Past this bugger. Roll past this bugger. And then head over this way. Oh no, he's back now. I was going to shoot him with this. He throws his spear at us. Lance, I should say. Come on, give me that back. There. And now but I think I need to alternate and go with this guy. Just to chain it all together. So there. down these stairs. This is the direction we're gonna follow. There we go. This one comes running over. Will you follow me into this bit? You saw him out of the range of the casters. Yeah, he will. There. Here we're clean, but there's a guy on that balcony there. Grab this item as well. Priest chime plus 8, it's nice. You coming in? Or is he gonna shit out in that doorway? Here he comes. Now we've got you and the guy further back. This balcony is now empty. Leaving you. And now we've got climb up. I do not remember climb up. Oh, don't tell me this is where the other Lancer is. It is. Nice. Down we go. This is our shortcut. Takes us down another level. Oh, we've got you. More levels down. Got you. Another Lancer. There's something that sounds very unhappy at the bottom as well. You get a backstab? Yeah, we can. Swing. We got a little ladder down there. For you. Ring of resistance plus 1. Got dogs down there. Fire projectile. I will take that advice. Can I hit the dog? Oh, that's no. What about this one? Yeah, we can. Go to this edge and see. Got you. No. Stay where I can hit you. Okay, maybe not. Any down this way? Don't like it. And you're just a drop with Modogs. 1, 2, 3, 4 in there. So you've gone back where you were. Come on. Got yours. Right, so now we've got multiple dogs in that room over there. Climb down. Sprint. And drink on the ladder because I can. I wonder if I go up here, now that they're drawn out, can I shoot any of them? You dealt with. That just hit the floor. You dealt with one. Go. There is the last one. Come on. Dogs dealt with. You are fine. What are you? What do you get us? Wilted dusk herbs, all of that for just rubbish. More floating bits of box. Silence. Fire ahead. Guts. Beware of dark spirit butthole. Dark spirit, stay calm. Weakness, defeat. Is there one down there? We've got... Yep. Who's she casting? Bitching out, isn't she? But her spells don't reach as far as mine. Apart from the tiny little homing spear. Yeah. difficulty, that's the one we want to avoid. Because... of a ranged battle, shall we? Itch. Ah, that's why this was a trap. I bet she was one of the ones that bitches out and heads. Yeah, look at all these blood pools. She'll have bitched out and ran down here behind this guy. Glad I avoided that. Now we have friend. Yes. Dude, we've got a job to do. Let's go. Whoosh. Now William Loy seeks the chaos. Right, so what is up this ladder? And will I have to do some more backtracking? A ladder, it's an elevator, not a ladder. Up here. Here is door. And where? Oh, we're here. This is where we get the eye. It's usually on here, so. Backtracking by going this way then. If there's a knight this way. I'm not sure if there is. But I want to make sure I've got all of them. The boss fight. That's what they do. But you're just a drop. Do a bit of backtracking, shall we? But we've got a shortcut. We can just go up the ladders and out the door, and we'll already be at the bridge. So yeah, this way. Backtrack a bit, go up this ladder. Oh, this dog dropped an item. And it was a human effigy as well, nice. So up we go. We get through here. Again. Again. There. Is it this one? Yeah, it is. We got out. And back the other way. That assassin in here that I saw, was she just out there somewhere? Because I went out here, looted this, came back. Ah, she was next to the door. Man. You dealt with, but you. Backstab. Everybody loves a good backstab. I am going through all the DLC, Alex. So I've got this DLC to do, which I've pretty much just got the last boss. And then after the DLC is done, I've got the final bosses of the main game. But yeah, the DLCs combined are about the length of the same main game. Ow. And now he's got a friend. Booger. So yeah, I've got the last boss of this DLC to do. Which shouldn't be too bad, to be honest. And then I've got the final boss as the main game. So, bugger all these guys, run past. Yeah, not too much to go. I've just got to... The main thing with this DLC, the frozen one, is basically... You've got to have help going into the fight. So you've got to go and find the knights of this kingdom who are locked away and free them. And I think I've found them all, but I'm not 100% sure. I'm double checking by going back through to where I should be. Head this way. This assassin here. Right. Back to this dude. No. Got you. Which you dealt with. We've got this bit up here which has all the dogs in the world. Go up the previously hidden ladder. I'm able to snipe a few. I don't think there's actually anything useful in here. Got you. I'm pretty sure I've got everything I needed from in here. Yeah, I have. There was just that balcony out there. So no, I don't need to go in here. Going in here last time was a complete waste. Means... down these steps. Alright, we could just go this way. Where we were going anyway. Pop some more life gems. We just head out that way. Yeah, because that door is where the other route brought us out. So I know I've cleared everything up to here, definitely. Head this way. Do 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 do. As along here. Here we've got... Oh yeah, it's this bit, innit? But first of all, dump these. Right. So, got you here. Oh yeah, this is the room with the golems. Gonna be fun. Golems. Pipeport. You've just found me at probably the toughest part of this DLC. Right, come golem. Yeah. Worth it though. Just because of the combos you get with it. Like this fist that I've got equipped, you get like proper fighting game combos with it. And you can even do flying kicks. But the best part of it, which you can surprise people with if they invade, is you can do this. You can throw Hadoukens. And then if you two-hand it, you get a slightly different moveset. Look at that caster. Oof. No worries. No worries, Amelie. You are catching us pretty much right at the end of Dark Souls 2. I can't kite you guys away a bit. I don't want to activate that golem. Oh, bring a friend as well. Right. There. Ow. Oh. Go away. Now I just need to draw this last one away, because if I kill it next to that big golem there, big golem activates. And I don't want that to happen, because he'll wreck those chests and I won't get what's in them. But I'll kite him away. Come on, follow me. Bit further. Bit further. Yeah, we should be good about here. We're back. Yeah, he was far enough away from the golem. Now I can smash it in peace. Right, so... jumping... monster ahead. So you're going to be a mimic, aren't you? Yep. Bloody mimics. Got you. Symbol of Avarice. Yay. Everybody loves Symbol of Avarice. Can run around with a mimic head. Yeah, increases soul absorption and item discovery, but steadily drains HP. What do we get in this? And here we get... Dragonbone and Twinkling Titanite. Handy. Repair the fist. Yeah, the bone fist works quite well, Bart, but you do have to repair it, because it wears down pretty quickly. Right, so, oh yeah, there's a bunch more golems up here, isn't there? Or there were. Oh yeah, they're at the top. So, I need to do a little kiting job again. Yeah, I see you up there. So you come down here. Oh yeah, these do bugger all to you. So, I need to get you far enough away. Whoop, no. I forgot how much damage these dudes did. Split them up. Come on, when do you stop following? Got you. Now you're on your own. Ah. There. I'm not even sure if I need to come this way, I'm just making sure. Because I've got to release the rest of the knights to help me through. And I want to make sure I've got all of them. So, we've still got the caster up here, don't we? So, you're inevitable, I think. So. Wail on that guy as much as we can before he fully activates. And now he should follow us. Yeah. Because I don't think killing him will activate the other golems, but I'm not sure. We shall see now. Oh, that went into me. So we can smash the other golems at our leisure. Oh no, wait. Test. So. Gotta be careful how I hit. I don't want to accidentally break the chest. If if I break the chest, I lose whatever's in it. Alright, so that one dying activated the other one. Lovely. Or not. Let me go. Oh, that didn't do anywhere near as much as I thought it was going to do. Right, come on. Now move away from that chest, because I'm not having you break that chest after the trouble I went through. Got you. Right, what's in this chest? Better be somewhat good. We have curved nil greatsword. Great curved sword with an ominous blade, one of the forbidden weapons sealed away by the Ivory King. Formed by rock, tree, and the remnants of a most peculiar soul. That the farther its wielder travels, the deadlier the blade becomes. Oh, that looked cool. And then big swipe and block. Oh, it's gonna follow up. Right, which way do we stairs up? And then we've got whatever's over this way. Ooh. Come on, come this way, I know you want to. Caster come any closer? No, he's not going to move, is he? The bugger. Hi, Emily. Right, you're going to go into that golem, so... And I barely hit it before it became active. As long as I kite you over this way a bit, you won't activate the other one, will you? No, you won't. Fly back. Got you. A few dealt with. If I head this way, we've got you. Sound. Oh, it's you down there. We can item down here. Layer ahead, try right, illusory wall, illusory wall. Aha! Flamebot flies, three of them. What's this? Are you a shortcut back or something? Let's go look. But first, friend! It was worth going this way, there was another friend. Hi there! No. Where does this lead? this leads back to the boss area. Cool. Back the other way. So we've got down through that secret door, wherever that leads. And we've got up these stairs here. So let's have a look at these stairs. Yeah, Bart is a master of terrible jokes. So, what's up here? Got oh, you just lead back to the boss area as well. Yeah, that was the fake out area, wasn't it? Cool. We'll go to the drop down then. Beep 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 beep. We'll see what was through that illusionary wall. And then, after that, just the boss fights, I think. Do 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 do. Right through here. And then through here. Or where is this? Oh! For the other side of the bonfire. Cool. Right. Kick it. So back this way, up these stairs, we got one of these dudes. That flying kick never works. Quite killy. Right, what's up here? A chest. And you lead back to that room. Oh. Fire clutch ring, you increase fire damage. Let's go. Oh. We got another Lancer out this way, don't we? Yep. Give me that backstab. Got him. And we got leggings. So, there was another dude out here, wasn't there? Yes. Bye. Message, message, message. Trigester. Yeah, you're all rubbish. And we got another drop down to him. Stop doing that flying kick. Manu is hiding because she's scared of you. Told me. But you lead back to the bonfire, and you're just another chest. Twin-headed great bow. Cool. Right, so that is everything explored. Time to go and fight the boss man. Or what was the cathedral? Right then. So, first of all, pop a humanity. I'm not gonna need any of my throwing stuff. And I shouldn't need my repair powder. So, right, before we actually do the boss fight, let's top up on crystals and repair powders. While I've got like 44 grand on me. Poor Manu. So, give me all them. And there we got the castle and splash out and repair powders. Dropped us something, and I closed the door instead. There. Green Blossom. Right. This dude up here will have a bunch of repair powders. And then we will be ready to do the boss.
Well, Argus, tell me. So soon, be safe on your trip.
Well, yeah, as long as you know what it is, you can at least start treating it then, can't you? But she's already got the gloves she wears to help, so they'll basically just be an upgrade for that. Boom. Right. Back to the boss zone. What area are you? Ah, I know where you are now. Yeah, could be. Hypermobility, because I think Manu's got that as well, she said before. Not, couldn't be weather related at all, is it? You've not had like a massive change in, hey look, it's Lucatiel. Like, it's not been massively hotter or colder at all, has it? Right, time for the most cinematic boss fight. But look, we got four knights waiting for us now. All these four knights here are our buddies coming down to help. Well, time for the cool guy moment. Yeah. Oh yeah. And now we have the other knights coming out of the fire. It's a fight between us. So yeah, I will be punching them a lot. I just need to... There. I'm just gonna let my buddies get in on the battle as well. But my guys cast like tons of spells and stuff as well, so well worth it. Right, so one of my guys has just sacrificed himself to heal, to seal up that there, that gate, to stop more of them coming in. So, need to start taking out the rest of them. Don't try that combustion on me. But yeah, these guys don't do a massive amount of damage, but... By these guys, I mean the friends who come down to help, but... Their main job is to... close up the doorways. Ah, the caster. Ow. Stop it. Let's do a flame snake again, so we'll get this one. Taken care of. Right. Another caster. Two casters. Right, me and you. Ooh. So yeah, that's the beginning of the boss fight. That's not even the boss yet. Right, round two. I think I need to try and be a bit more aggressive at the start, so there's less of the guys to fight later on. Oh. We get the salute again. And the cool guy entrance. Whoosh. Let's rush them. You. fire snake. It tracks you as well, does that spell. Head back out this way a bit and we'll fight each other. So who was low? Yeah, you, Caster, come here. And then you. They got me. This bit is rough. I do not remember it being this rough. Doing the stab and the fire. I definitely need to be more aggressive so we don't get overwhelmed. I'm just gonna be careful. How many of those Elizabeth mushrooms do I have? Might be worth popping one of those. Oh yeah, I got 10. Give me one of them mushrooms. And then a bright bug as well. Put you on the bar. Put you on the bar. Because the Elizabeth mushroom is like constant healing over time. And the bright bug gives me a bunch more defense and attack. We will pop both of those. Right bug. Elizabeth mushroom. Let's go. Drugs. Got you. And he dropped a soul. Nice. By my own guys. Right, who's next? You're a caster. Come on. Ow. Combustion got me from the guy behind. Right. I also missed hitting the guy I was aiming at like 5 times. But bright bug and mushroom did seem to go well, so we'll grab one of you. Not two, and we'll grab another 2 bright bugs. They're brutal, and it's not even the boss. Like, after I beat them is when the boss comes out. So, bright bug, Elizabeth mushroom, and then wade in. Go! Get away! Head back towards the middle of the room, that's a bit less chaotic. Right. You. Hey, Chua! Another mushroom. Right, Caster, you are next. Oh, you're a caster on lower health. Here. This is much better. I was more aggressive this time, so there's a lot less of them when the other guys are sacrificing themselves. May as well pick up my souls while I'm here. Right. Just you left, innit? And now the boss man comes in. So let's pop this. And here comes the king. Come on. Come on, buddy. It's fight time. Oh, he's going right straight for one of his own knights. Look, he does backflips and all sorts, this dude. Right, what's he casting? He's making his sword bigger. Ow, that hurt. Heal, please. And he got me. Not bad though, I got him low. So I think it is time to stock up on more of those mushrooms and bright bugs. So we'll get, I don't want all seven of them. We'll get three of them. How many bright bugs have we got? We'll get two of the bright bugs, and we'll take a bunch of the radiant crystals. But your bright bug. Yeah, the opening to this fight is the worst bit, Trua. Like, you should see how chaotic it is right at the opening. So right, get Bright Bug ready. So I will pop Brightbug when I actually see the king this time, because I popped it a bit early last time. But Brightbug, Elizabeth Mushroom, and then we wail on this guy. Or I will do it, my friends have shown up. One down. Two down. Three down. Hopefully we cast it. Now we pop second mushroom. We'll pop crystal while we're at it. You get dead already. Sorted. Right. Who have we got left? It looks like my final health is going to have a fair bit more health this time as well. Which will help with the king. Right, come on. One. I got two. Have I got two? No, you're supposed to seal up this door, you mad lad. Well, bugger it. One of you was supposed to have sealed up this door here. It's bugged. Oh no, it's not. He just didn't want to cast his thing until the end, because he's a nut. Means I'm going into this final part of the boss fight with an ad. And a caster at that. Come on, just get dead already. Right, now practice.
Go, go, Trouble Ranger, you mighty punching Trouble Ranger.
Thanks, Trouble. Too early. Didn't help that the I had an ad at the beginning. Usually all the doors are blocked up before. So yeah, we'll just go in with the Radiant Life Gems this time. Yeah, usually the four doors that the ads come through are blocked up before the king comes in. And I think it just sort of bugged that time, so. To hear a landing. See, if I can catch one of them, I can stun him. But your door is now. Oh no! caught by a wild caster. Get the rest of the mushrooms. We'll stock up on drugs. Stock up on. Bright books. Anything else can be useful here? No, you take ages to use. Take a bunch of these in. No. So this is going to be the all-out attempt. Got my bright bugs. Got a bunch of healing. Make myself human again as well. In we go. Straight in the flames wave. Instant death. The king himself isn't too bad as long as I can actually get past this bit. Also, you can totally cheese this fight if you play a cleric, because you can use your healing spells and they will affect the knights that are on your side. On. Cheeky fucker with a pixel of health. Ah! Bet he's dead. Get this guy who's been trapped. Or not. Really need to take out this caster. I'm dealt with. Oh, is that you going filling up the last one? Better be. Yeah, it is, right. Take this guy out. That door gets sealed. Take this guy out. Got you. Right. All the doors are sealed. Time for the king. My friend has a decent bit of health as well. Hey Greg! I'm doing the coolest boss. To be more careful with my hits. Hi Greg. I am on the final boss for the DLC. And it is painful. I did get him down to like a quarter of his health early on. And then I had one attempt where they decided not to seal that door until King himself showed up. Ow, not a combustion, please. There. Got too greedy. Right. I can summon Luca Teal for this fight because she's a badass, but I want to try and do it without a summon. First time I ever did this fight, I did it with one of my friends helping me. But I want to try and do it without. Magic pixel. That's the two low health ones. So take you out. Take you out. Take that armor as well. Ow! Stupid casters. Actually, we've got two casters and we really need one of these gone. Take you, we've got a tiny bit of health. One more time. I'm not going to have a helper for the boss because he's about to die, but it does mean all the doors will be sealed by the time the boss comes in. Yeah, the closed captions are wonky. We want to Elizabeth Mushroom for this bit, don't we? But wait until I can see him, and then pop it. So my friend here is going to die in like a single hit. So it's all on me. There he goes. That was the wrong time to heal. Good. I might give it a couple more goes and then get Luca Teal in to help. Down. Three down. Why are you all ganging up on that one guy over there? And Flame Snake, because there's two casters. Nice. Nope. I got the combustion to the face and I just saw the flame snake coming in from the side. This will be the last attempt doing it solo. After that, I'll get Luca Teal in. expected, this fight is so much easier with my usual weapons as well. Because I usually go with big weapons. Like, when you get two of them next to each other like that, you're just hitting both of them constantly. Like, you can kinda do it with these if you switch back and forth, but it's really risky. And I missed. I can use the human effigy to do it, to restore my life back to max, but there's a limited amount of those in the game, and I've still got the end bosses of the game to do. So I want to save some of them for that as well. Time to get Lucatiel in. She can show how much of a badass she is. But yeah, the casters are the problem. Like, the close range spell they have is the same one that I have here. It's called Great Combustion, and it's literally that, but it'll take off good 80% of my health. So, item box. You go in there. Yeah, we've not got any mushrooms or anything left, do we? Bugger it. Pop one of you. Pop it up to max. And the only time you can summon help is when you're in this human form as well, so... Here's Lucatiel. Oh, it's Twiggy. Ah, here's Lucatiel's sign. We've got Twiggy, the Bowmaster, and Lucatiel, the Duelist. These two are coming with us. And yeah, Lucatiel is a badass. Boobadoo, boo, 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 boo. Yeah, the first time I ever did this fight, it was me and a friend doing it. I was playing a caster, like a full wizard, with like buffed melee gear, and he was playing like a full strength build. And between us, we just battered our way through these knights. They stood no chance. The downside of these summons is the bosses do get more physical resistance, and so do these adds. But having more people is supposed to make up for it, which I think it will. Because I can stun them. And a little bit of added damage from our friends will help finish them off. Caster. You've been sealing up that one. Right. Get you then, shall we? Oh, two doors sealed. Casters, I'll try to. There. Now we just wait around a bit for one of these knights to seal up the gap. That'll be that. So you're going. Close that quick before the king turns up. One, over there. See, what these guys do is they actually sacrifice themselves. They release the frozen winds and should be sealed with ice. So now we've got Twiggy, Lucatiel, and one of the knights. Because you always get one of the knights as long as you find all of them. Versus the king. So you can see we do less damage to him because he has more physical resistance now, but numbers should make up for it. Casting. He's doing the giant sword and now the spikes. See, that sword hitting me on the backswing then. That's how big it gets when he casts that spell. It's always disappointed you can never get that spell yourself though. It is his special thing. Pile a bit of damage on while he's stunned. He really doesn't like Twiggy. It's actually a bad place to be. Twiggy's dead. Twiggy's more of an archer than anything else. And as you can see, Lucatiel can tank like crazy. And he spells me. That's No, get away. Early on the roll. He swings really late on that. See if there's anything useful in here. I don't think there is. Grab Twiggy, grab Lucatiel. Yeah, better strength, better dex, because my weapon scales off both. The first door getting seen. I forgot to add these back onto my bar. And I failed at doing it then as well. There. Two silver. Right, you better go and close that door right now. Come on, guys, this way. Right, come on, close the door. Close the door. He's not doing it. We're gonna have another add-in when the boss comes in. So. This is what happened last time. One of the knights decided to cheap out and didn't seal this door. So yeah, we had another ad come in. Now he decides to seal it. I need to take this guy out quick. See one of Twiggy's arrows come flying at him. Look at the spikes, that's probably going to take out Quiggy. Yeah. I literally can't heal in that last phase. If I try and heal at all, he'll get me. Oh, wait. I have a healing spell. I forgot. Right, so I can't use any more human effigies if I want to save them for the last boss. So this spell that I've just attuned that I completely forgot about, Warmth, heals me and these guys. So, I wonder if Yeah, that's much faster. This is not the last boss. This is the last boss of this DLC. I still have the last boss of the main game to do. Oh. We've gone back just to the regular Cestus for now. Just to see. Because it's a much faster attack and it doesn't lock me into the combo as much. It might be easier for actually avoiding stuff. About the same, to be honest. You get away from Twiggy. It would also be much better if I could backstab these bastards, but I can't. He's going sealing the second door. Right, so, show you what I mean about this spell. If anybody comes near it, and look at he'll come over here. Get healed. And you, Twiggy. It doesn't heal a massive amount, but it does heal. Right, so we're going to have another ad in the boss phase again. So we'll drop another warmth just as the boss comes in. We have this nice little healing area. Now we really need to take out this ad fast, so... He's going to sort out the door. Right, ad's done with. Oh fuck, it kills the boss as well. Ah well, at least we got Lucatiel almost at full for this. Spikes. Staggered him. Right, he's going to do spikes again. Thank you. spikes. Oh no. Kill more, please. Right, he's looking at somebody else. We just need to trap him a good bit. Right, the knight is down. Oh, yeah. Yeah, that warmth to heal up those two during the final part was well worth it. And give me that crown, please. Yeah, boy. Faint heat lingers in the ancient crown. First try my ass. And now, ride this back to the top.
It's fucking dead, mate.
Got the last boss of the DLC done, Spike. Onto the final boss of the actual game. So yeah, Manus, the guy at the end of the first game, the big dark piece, the big dark beast thing. This is one of his daughters, technically. How frightened I was. A frail thing. But yeah, they were all ruled by a different emotion. So Vendrick's wife, Nashandra, was ruled by greed. So she got him to go and invade the giants, take things over, expand his kingdom and everything. You had Elana, who was the squalid queen, who was disgust. And she was obsessed with dirt and poison and all sorts. And that screwed up the entire kingdom. And then when the dragon there turned up, corrupted that as well, so that's where you end up with a poison kingdom. And then you had, who was the other one? Nidalia, who was anger, and she basically wasted the entire kingdom and turned it into ash, turned all the soldiers to ash, burned them away. That's where you get the fire DLC. And then this poor lady who was ruled by fear and actually turns out to be kind of a good person. Until the end of time. Because this kingdom was slowly being taken over by the Chaos. Like the Chaos Flame. And she basically was afraid of them, so she joined with the king to help fight back. She joined onto a strong king to protect her with all of his knights, and that's where all this frozen stuff comes from, is her holding back the Chaos Reign. The knights with it, I pray. So, thing about this DLC is you've got these Lois souls. Soul of the Knights of Lois. The Knights of Lois were taken by Chaos and lost all sense of purpose and being. The few woeful souls that trudged back home were guided by faint self, vestige of self. The soul is pure sorrow. Only Alsana can put it to... so she's called Alsana. So these souls that you can collect, that we got off a few of those knights, you can gift to her, and eventually you can get to the top of those stairs, but I can't remember what it does if you do. I'll see if I've got any here.
pop 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 pop
pop. So we've got a king crown. So we need to grab the other crowns. Where are they? Got quite a collection now. There we go. Crown of the Old Iron King, Crown of the Sunken King, King's Crown. We've got four crowns. Switch you back to Bone Fist. Round one. Oh yeah, I was looking for Lice Souls, wasn't I? He's just getting it out of his system is all. How many Lice Souls? Lava. Three. Don't think she gives anything for three. Have a look. But yeah, you can basically farm this area and help other people with that fight to get more Lice Souls. So if I go over here. Yeah, nothing. Oh well. Time to go pay a visit to Vendrick. Or the memory of Vendrick. And then I can show you something really cool. But first, to Majula. So the whole reason I did it this way were... I went and did the DLC before the final bosses of the game. It's for a very specific reason. You give me more of those.
Thanks.
So if I travel to these crypt entrance, and I've just got to leg it, I think, because we're gonna go back to Vendrick's memory. I wonder. That works. Thank you for the host, Spike. This way, through here, past these nerds. Ignore this dude. So we need to go to Vendrick's memory. All the way along here. So I'm just gonna one run it. The dude's gonna ring the bell and spawn in a load of stuff, but as long as I sprint, it shouldn't be a problem. Bye. You're not allowed in here. Right, so Bendrick's already dead because I killed him earlier, but his memory still exists. Well, let's see what he says about killing the other kings. Vendrick.
Seeker of fire, deliverer of crowns. What do you see in the flames? Find the crowns and your own answers. The crowns hold the strength of lords from times long past. Seek adversity. As befits you, seeker of fire, coveter of the throne.
Right, so I've done this correctly. The crown back on.
I too sought fire once. With fire, they say, a true king can harness the curse. Seeker of fire, it grows deeper still. Flame, oh, flame. Seeker of fire, I see you've subdued another foul creature. One of the father of the abyss spawn. That the abyss once had form, but then and yet traces of its existence endured. Each fragment thirsting for power. My dear Chandra was one such fragment. A feeble, tiny thing that thirsted for power more than any other, driven by insatiable lust for a worthy vessel. One day fire will fade. Men will be free from death, left to wander eternally. Dark will again be ours.
Hurry
up.
And in
our true shape, we can bury the false legends of yore. Only, is this our only choice? Seek.
There we go. Now our crown has been upgraded. So he's basically just been telling us each of the crowns has power in it from previous lords, and that you can harness the curse, if you have that power. Now, heat radiates from the ancient crowns because we have harnessed the fire. So, you have to have all of the crowns to do this, but I will show you. Now we are the true monarch. So watch what the crown does now.
_
Oh, I just died. I should be going hollow. But I'm not. So that's the power of the crowns. They let you bypass hollowing. So you can now die infinitely and never worry about hollowing. At all. You are always going to be human.
Imagine dying.
Anyway, time to go for the last boss. So yeah, you're now immune to hollowing. That's the power of the kings. But we need to go down this way. Means we need the king's ring on. This is the final boss of the game, and I need to pick up a couple of things before we go down there. But Lysols can go back in there, bombs can go back in there. Grab all of the healing. Grab those. Grab those. Because this is going to be a boss rush. Hey, look who it is.
My journey is already complete. My name is Shanalot. The dragon gave me this name, for I was born with a nun. I was born of dragons, contrived by men. By ones who would cozen fate herself. They are the ones who created me. But they failed. I did not come out as intended. Fate would not be bested, and men were cursed once again. If you proceed, Nashandra will come after you. Knowing that you will take the throne and link the fire.
You can if you want.
She covets the first flame and the great soul. Put Nashandra to rest.
So this is Shanalot, she eventually tells you. Bart can do it. If Bart's still around. But yeah, she's born of the dragons. She's part dragon. And she's by the she's voiced by the same woman who voices O'Hare in Preacher, if any of you watch Preacher. Alex wants a bet to see if I die for the rest of the game. But now we are heading down to the throne. Yeah, she voices Tulip O'Hare. Same woman. Well, this being the final boss, you actually get a choice of summons for it as well. You got Vengarl, big badass. See him there in his armor. Yet Radley, he was just a regular old knight. And you have Benhart, who promised to help you whenever you needed it. So they are your options of summons for the final boss. But we're not going to bother with any of them. We're going to do all this solo if we can. Oh, we'll let Bart set a bet up. Or I'll do it if I can remember how. Prediction? Cool. But yeah, the advantage of the crown is because you're always human with the crown on, you never go all or you always have the option to summon. So those humanities I was worried about, human effigies, don't matter anymore. Because I've got infinite humanity. Prediction is up. Bet your channel points. We'll start the fight. So, Throne Watcher, Throne Defender. Two dudes with a World of Warcraft mechanic. Oh, I do a decent amount to them. That guy also has the best shield in the game. Zone Defender's shield is like the 100% physical block. Like, crazy amount of stability.
Don't get distracted now, lol.
So they try and cover each other's backs. Now they both go for lightning. This is the bit where it can get really hairy.
Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee, his name is Trouble Bay CEEE.
Caught by the lightning swords.
Pay up, bitches.
Oh yeah. My rings. The stagger is gonna do nothing to these guys, so. Blade, steel protection, chloranthi. Maximum load, Dr. Defense, Lightning Defense, Fire. Protection, HP, Stamina, Maximum Load. Slows Degradation, Petrification.
Imagine getting your money stolen by a fake account, lol.
Right, we will go for second dragon, I think. HP, stamina, and load, because no way in hell am I going to stagger them. So, Stone Ring is worthless. Well, away we go. Wait for the door to open again. Alex just stealing everybody's points on the bot account. Switch you for second dragon. Bit more stamina, a bit more health, slightly better rolling. Come on, Watcher and Defender, let's go. Getting an opening at first is the hard bit. There's a cheese for these guys as well, that speedrunners tend to use. Come here, you.
Titty stab underscore.
No! Forgot there was the lip to the edge of the room. King's ring to open the door. Alex is just raking in the points. One, go. Switch you back, second dragon. Wish this run wasn't so long as well. They could have at least put a bonfire next to the door or something. So remember, Aaron, there is a lip at the edge of the room where you can fall in. He's popping his lightning. But it means he won't defend as much anymore. No more shield for him. Always lightning right out. So he recasts. Damage him too much because now you got lightning. Right, you're down. Now for the reason why this is a Dark Souls boss. Or why I called it a World of Warcraft boss, I should say. You have to take them down at the both at the same time, otherwise one starts healing the other. There we go. But we're not quite done yet. Boss 2. Yeah, and the Chandra. This bitch. Now, I am immune to curse. Or I'm immune to hollowing at least. And curse increases hollowing.
Now, be one.
I did kill. Time for boss 2. You ruined Vendrix. Oh, it's still reducing my life. That was unexpected. I'm just going to have to kite her. Fires our laser beam. This is where she pulls in more cursed things, and there's no real good place to go. We'll just have to try and beat her before it becomes too much of a problem. Boss two down. Bye, Nashandra.
Many monarchs have come and gone.
But we're not done yet.
One drowned in poison, another succumbed to flame. Still another slumbers in the realm of ice. Not one of them stood here.
So now for the bit you might not have been expecting.
You, conqueror of adversity. Give us your answer.
Now for boss three. Oh shit, he does fire damage when I'm close to him. It's gonna be fun. Shit, my weapons are at risk. Pops up, puts his flame out, and I can get a few hits in. Shouldn't have used the divine blessing really, but no, get away. Yeah, I don't think it may be possible for us to do this. What are you doing? Is that a nuke? It is. Yeah, bitch. No, not like that. Yeah, it's just that I can't get close to him without him burning me. So get... Yeah, he doesn't burn when he's casting. Swap you out for flash sweat, please. It's okay, Bart. This is, however, the very final boss of the game. And I should probably not have fire arrows on. Give me lightning. So. No worries, Bart. Yeah, I'm gonna go on for a bit longer. I'm definitely gonna finish this. I'm not gonna stop until I've kicked Alia out anyway. I was hoping I was able to get the three boss run again then. But no, that burn was a bit too savage. I was hoping I'd be able to beat Watcher, Defender, and then Aldia all in one go. Which is why I packed all those healing items on me at once. Just in case. Right, so. Flash set sweat for the fire resist. Ooh, that's a lot. But come on. Come here, Aldia. No, I rolled off. Fuck. Did not realise I was that close to him. What do we have? Right, I'll throw another prediction up for you. There you go, you've got Glaucon. You got a minute to decide. More betting. I think this might be one as well where we want to swap to double Cestus so I can get the quicker hits and then in and out. No worries, Truer. I should have cast Flash Sweat, shouldn't I? Oh well. Yeah, the Bone Fist is cool and all, but it locks me in, which I need to be able to move fast to get out just as that appears. So he's doing these. Rushing. Only got a couple of hits that time. Flames got bigger. Oh yeah, his flames got much bigger. Yeah, switching to Cestus was a good choice. Lets me dodge in and out quicker if I need to. No. Oh, I got too greedy. I thought I had him. There we go, new prediction, new attempt, but I reckon I've probably got it this time. I even forgot to swap the King's Ring back on. Right, let's go. Let's go. Yeah, petrol station food over here is a rip-off. Absolute terrible quality. It costs about twice as much as just buying one from a shop. Oh, he's doing the big fireball. Doing these homing fireballs. Where was he popping up over there? Right, I've got time to drink. Still got me, that's rubbish. Come on. Right, where's he gonna pop up? Over here. But he's gonna freak out and do big flames. But I'll recast flash right while we can. Six hits. Now he's doing Utah's great swords. Big flames. Come on. Nito's great swords again. Right, you're dead, buddy. There we go, last boss dead. Bye bye, Aldia. Whoop whoop.
I lost everything, but remain here patiently. A throne will certainly receive you. But the question is.
So.
Light, dark.
Or something else entirely.
We have beat every boss in the game. Well, I say every boss in the game, all but the challenge bosses, but I'm going to do them on Discord. So, proceed to the throne. Go and make ourselves queen. So, we'll reactivate these golems. All you do is become a bridge. Oops.
You who link the fire.
There.
You who bear the curse. Once the fire is linked, souls will flourish anew, and all of this will play out again. It is your choice to embrace or renounce this.
So yeah, this is the game telling you basically, yeah, you can link the fire, but stuff will just repeat and repeat and repeat. Yeah, Dave, you missed it. Came in right at the end. So you come in just in time to see me take the throne.
Take your throne. What lies ahead, only you can see.
There. And that is Dark Souls 2. Yeah, Dark Souls 2 is an odd one. Like, Dark Souls 1 became popular, like way popular than Demon Souls ever was. So Dark Souls 2 started getting made, and they decided to experiment with a load of stuff. So there were things people loved, like power stancing. Everybody loved power stancing. People did enjoy the health reduction thing, because it came originally from Demon's Souls, but a lot of people hated it as well. I didn't really mind it, it's not that bad a problem.
Dark Souls poo underscore?
Or poo you. But there are loads and loads of problems with the making of the game, like changing directors and things like that. So. That's why certain areas look a lot more polished than others.
Time to play Dark Souls P underscore.
Yeah, Dark Souls 3 is next. Which reminds me, we need to do a vote, don't we? So. Got a poll. So I asked for a bunch of ideas on Discord. Like ideas of stuff to play, and I've decided I'm going to combine a couple of them for what to play in Dark Souls 3. So,
pole dance underscore. Hot tub underscore.
Thank you. So the plans are basically so the three options are going to be a naked rapier run, so no armor, only using the rapier. Option two is going to be double spear, so I'm using two spears, one in each hand, stabbing everything. And option three is fat wizard. So I've done melee a lot in the past two games. Option three was play a wizard and always be fat rolling, always. So I'll put the bolt pull up for 3 minutes. And if you really want to, you can try and skew the vault, but it's going to be expensive. So there we go. The poll is up. You got 3 minutes to decide what you want and to try and skew it with points if you want to. So yeah, option one is I don't wear any armor at all and my only weapon is a rapier. Option two is use two spears and whatever else. And option three is I go full wizard, but I have to fat roll. And what we will do is we will boot up Dark Souls 3. I'll make the character now and then that'll probably be end of stream. Do want to say though, out of all the Dark Souls games, Dark Souls 2 has my favourite music by far. Like, out of all of them. Like, Dark Souls 1, Gwyn's theme is pretty good. So is Artorias' theme, but Dark Souls 2, you've got Majula, you've got this end theme, you've got the openings. The themes for Watcher and Defender, for Fume Knight, all of those are all amazing tracks in this one. Oh, you lost all your points voting. Not long left. But yeah, Majula theme is brilliant. Like, there's a YouTuber I used to watch who doesn't do Dark Souls or anything anymore, but he used to do it a lot. He used to do all the PvP, and he was called Sunlight Blade. And he, even though he hated Dark Souls 2, he still used the Majula theme for all of his intro and outro stuff. There we go, the poll is finished. We are going to be a fat wizard. So, that'll be mean I will start as one of the casting classes. I'll be going all in on the spell casting. And I will be wearing armor that makes me fat roll. Which means my rolling is going to have to be really precise. Like, some bosses is not too bad, because there are ways you can avoid them and stuff, but...
Trouble base, through smoke, thunder, flames, he's coming to punch in your fucking face.
Hey, I made it a poll, and I made it fair. And I made it so you could skew it your way if you wanted, if you had the points. The way elections work, if you have the right money, you can just buy the win. Just think of it as an important life lesson. There you go, mild-mannered Peter Serafinowicz. Oh yeah, this is actually unskippable as well, I forgot. Oh yeah, shield design contest. Before the game came out, they had a competition where you could design a shield and it got included in game. I can't remember which ones won. Crazy software and stuff they used. Throw specific fights just so Alex can get more points. Sounds like a plan. If only I got something out of that. So, it just bumps you back into the game now. And Dark Souls 1 would throw you directly into New Game Plus. This doesn't. This lets you actually pick. So, good way. You go in there. Got all of our crowns and stuff. And here is our... Nah, not in Dark Souls 3, truer. Dark Souls 3, there's a lot of stuff with resistances to magic. And, yeah, fat rolling as well. So, no dodging. But yeah, there we go. Here's our finishing stats for Dark Souls 2. 20 vigor, 17 endurance, 6 vitality, 10 attunement, 50 strength and dex, 38 adaptability, 10 intellect, and 8 faith. And we punched everything. Right. So, let's go make our fat wizard, shall we?